我很想去中国，可是现在我不可以。I'm planning on going 2022。
突如其来的美梦，是你离去时卷起的泡沫。季节石头默默地走，孔雀从盆栽上而过。突如其来的念头，我将画上流星的泥泊。明亮的夜，漆黑的忧愁，统统来自夜空。我会披星戴月的想你，我会奋不顾身的前进。远方原来越来越熙熙，您是前方身后的助力。
Today we have Miles joining us and share with us some of his thoughts on Chinese and his own experience. Welcome, Miles.
Thank you for having me. I'm really excited.
Thank you for joining us. So you're American, right?
对，我是美国人。
你是美国人。So you've ever heard of that, ancient joke about Americans only speak one language? Yeah, what do you think about that? So now you're learning Chinese. We've just enjoyed that beautiful song. That was awesome.
I think it's a true stereotype. I mean, most Americans don't really speak multiple languages. Like most people that are like Americans born here, if you ask them if they speak another language, they'll say, well, I took like 4 years of Spanish in high school, or I studied some French in high school. Most other cultures will like teach the young people in that culture English, because English is a very widespread language for business and it's kind of used everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
And so a lot of Americans, you can get by most places only speaking English, or you can find somebody in a foreign country that speaks English that can help you.
Yeah.
So you're never really put.
Perhaps I should conduct this interview in Chinese.
Yeah. I'd have to ask you to repeat yourself. It'd be a slower interview, but we'd get it done.
And I'm going to sound like a broken record. That's what I'm going to be. So learning Chinese, tell us a funny story. You're exploring this language. Apparently, you're learning it on your own as well. Congratulations, by the way. So what are the funny things that you can share with us?
Well, so I have, I'll do a couple lessons a month with my teacher, and Ta Shi Taiwanren. And so basically she acts as kind of like a native speaker that I can ask questions to and make sure that my tones are correct and I'm not just saying random things. And early on in my lessons, I only knew like a few vocabulary here and there. So we were having conversation and I knew how to say, I knew cha, like tea, like 我很喜欢 cha. But I don't really like tea that much. But for the sake of the conversation, like, I was like, oh, I love tea. And she's like, what's your favorite kind of tea? And the only one I knew was 绿茶. So like 我很喜欢绿茶, and she's like, and so I just got kind of like in this 10-minute conversation about how much I love tea when I don't even like tea, but it was like it's all I knew how to say. And I kind of run into that situation a lot whenever I'm speaking with native speakers, is I have a very limited vocabulary right now, so my conversations tend to only go in one direction because that's the only thing I know how to talk about. And so sometimes for the sake of continuing a conversation, I'll just talk about how much I love tea, even though I don't really like it that much.
You mentioned that you have a Chinese teacher. Do you have a lot of like Chinese friends around? And do you find it's difficult to make a real connection with Chinese people? Some of them saying, it's kind of difficult to approach a Chinese people, but once you know them, you can, become really good friends with them. So what's your
experience? Yeah, 我同意，我觉得中国人是 they're always really open to talk with me. They're very excited that I'm speaking their language and they want to practice. I think
we all got so excited to be like, oh, this man is speaking Mandarin.
Yeah, and it's really cool. Like, so there I've had almost nothing but positive experiences going out and trying to practice with people. Especially it can be a challenge because a lot of the people that I'm speaking with are older Chinese people, because I'm going to Chinatown and going to bookstores, and most Chinese people, like, so I actually just made a friend coming up the elevator to my apartment. I got in the elevator and I saw somebody. I try not to stereotype because I don't just want to be like, hey, are you Chinese? And they're like Korean, and it can be kind of insulting. So I try to like have conversation.
Well, even worse if you ask them, where are you from? It puts you in a dangerous place.
Exactly. And so it's kind of like, it's kind of tricky. So normally I try to have a conversation and I can tell a lot of times based on the accent, if they're Korean or Japanese or Chinese or some other. And so I was talking with him and it sounded like he was Chinese and he had ordered Chinese food. So I basically just asked him, you know, like, 你是中国人吗? And he goes, oh my gosh, that is so impressive. And so I got his phone number and we've been hanging out a little bit. So I think it's hard at first to connect just because of the culture difference. You know, there's so much difference in the culture and the slang and all these sort of things that it can be hard at first. But if you put in some effort into learning their side of things, then I think it's really easy. And most Chinese people have been extremely excited to connect and be friends. And so it's been a great experience so far.
Oh, that is awesome. So with that being said, I'm curious about your take on some of the less fortunate situations in, you know, maybe not just the States, but in the other countries as well. Due to the pandemic, that people have some certain stereotype about Chinese people and they might have this hate. So I'm just kind of like curious, what's your take on this and how are, from your observations, how are Chinese people doing overseas
or yeah.
in traders in general?
Uh-huh. I mean, obviously my view is a bit limited because, you know, I'm not Chinese. I'm not in Chinese cultures a lot. So I wouldn't be experiencing a lot of that. I have seen on the news that there's been an increase of hate crimes towards not even just Chinese people, but Asian people in general. And I think, you know, I think it's awful. And I just think that like people, when people get scared, we don't really act from like a place of love. We start to get defensive and fearful. And whenever we're in that state, we don't treat others very well. And when we have easy scapegoats, like, you know, it's easy to be frustrated that the whole world is shut down and that I lost my job or like all these different things. It's easy to be angry about those things. And a lot of people take the easy way out by like blaming a certain race of people, because it's easier to not like deal with the world and just blame a certain ethnicity. So while I don't agree with it, I do see where it comes from. And I think that by learning about other cultures and by learning other languages, you can help kind of minimize the possibility of you falling into those traps.
I think that's really well said. I hope you guys enjoyed his music and we will see you next time. And bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye.
Bye, Taijian.